YouTube. It's your boy Damian Cryer, and I'm back with another video. So today, guys, as you can tell by the title, I'm doing a Popeye's chicken mukbang. So that's what we got. We got the biscuits, the vegetables. So anyway, guys, hope you guys are having a wonderful and blessed Saturday today. Now, you might notice I'm talking a little low because my grandkids is currently sleeping and I don't want to make too much noise to wake them up. So I decided to wait until it was nap time and then to do this video for you guys. So if you guys are not familiar with my social media, all of my links to all of my social media is in the description box down below. So feel free to go check that out after the video. Also, guys, if you have not subscribed to the Cryer family, what are y'all waiting on? Get out of the comment section and get up there and turn that bell on so you'll be notified every time I drop a video on my channel. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for your chance to get a shout out. We do post notification shout outs at the end of almost every video. Sometimes I do slip up, but for the most part, we do shout outs at the end of all of our videos. So guys, today I'm going to be talking about a variety of stuff. Cause like on my channel, as you know, the channel is growing. And I am so grateful. Thank all you guys who and women who recently subscribed to the Cryer family. I feel really honored to have you guys to join my channel. So I just feel so grateful, man. And a lot of people have been wondering, like, you know, what's next for Damian Cryer as far as like what the future holds in 2020. So I'm gonna just say this. I believe in my heart that 2020 is gonna probably be the best year ever. As far as what the future holds, I'm not for sure. Some people have been asking me that, would I be collabing with other people again? Will I be collabing with other YouTubers? Or will I be introducing a new girlfriend? Cause like a lot of people know my history. Like in 2019, I had 3 females on my channel. And so like people are like, well, are you gonna have another female on your channel? What's gonna happen, this and that? So the thing is, man, you never know what's gonna happen tomorrow, but I don't anticipate that happening soon, but you never know what's gonna happen in the near future. You never know what God has in plan for you or what God has in store. None of us does. I mean, for all I know, we're not promised to be here tomorrow. I may not be here tomorrow. You may not be here tomorrow. So we can never pre-plan ahead what tomorrow is gonna bring. So we'll just have to just wait it out and then see what happens. I mean, I've been getting hit with a lot of questions like, what's going on? But yeah, I know how it is, man. Some things is not for the internet. As you guys know how I am, man. Everything is not for YouTube. So we'll just wait and see what the future holds and then just see what happens. But as far as I know, as of right now, I have to say, no, not at the moment. So I was actually kind of surprised. Some of my comments, well, a lot of my comments is like, I don't know if my subscribers are talking to each other on the phone, but I had like 6 back-to-back comments and they were like almost the same identical comment. And the question was, Mr. Cryer, do you plan on having any more kids? I'm like, whoa, where in the heck did that question come from? Where did that question come from? Do I have any plans of having any more kids? I don't know. Why is it, my camera's getting brighter? Sorry about that, guys. It's getting really bright. Again, I don't know what the future holds. Do I want another child? Of course I do. Whether it's a boy or girl, It don't really matter to me if it's a boy or girl. But yes, the answer is I do want another child. But do I plan on having another child? In order to plan on having a child, you have to first be with someone. As you guys know, I am single. I've been single for a few months now, maybe 3 months. I believe it's too soon to even be talking about having a kid. I've only been single for like a couple months. So I'm not the type of dude really to just jump in and out of cars like that. But I think the responsibility of having a baby, you know, you want to be financially stable. You want to be in a really good financial place. So it's something that I do want is another baby, but am I working on having another baby right now? Not at the current moment. So that's the question to that. Now, someone else also asked, Damian, are you currently dating anyone? That was like one of the biggest questions out there. Like, are you dating anyone currently? Are you currently seeing anyone? And I'm like, well, let's just say I'm not currently seeing anyone right now. Kind of talking a little bit. Y'all know how that go. I mean, I'm kind of talking right now. But this, it's like, it's kind of touch and go. Y'all know like the conversations where y'all talk for a minute. Person don't answer the phone sometimes. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Or you text, they don't respond till like hours later. So it's one of those situations where I'm gonna say, I'm not dating anyone right now, but I'm kind of feeling around a little bit. So that's something that I am doing. So, but it's gonna be kind of, you know, quite a while for me before I really get serious about someone. Because people, man, you don't know what people's intentions are. Like, I gotta excuse the noise. That's baby Nova back there. I just put her in her walker. I'm surprised she hasn't kind of like scooted her way over here yet towards Pawpaw. But yeah, I wanna just get to really, you know, I don't wanna jump into something too quick. And what I mean by person who texts is kind of slow, responds kind of slow, I'm that person I'm talking about. I don't really respond too much to a lot of messages that I get now. I kind of look at it when I get them and be like, oh, okay, cool. Thanks for the compliment. Keep it moving. But it's like, you just got to really just watch who you date now, man, because, you know, if you throw yourself out there, you're most likely going to get something that you don't want. So I think more or less, like, I'm not really looking for a relationship at this time. I'm not really looking to even get serious with anyone. Just kind of like having some fun, hanging out or something like that. Y'all know what I mean. But as far as like, I'm not looking really to get serious with anyone. I want to just kind of like just keep my options open. Because like, if you don't keep your options open and close the door too quick, you could miss your blessing. I mean, this is a time right now that I'm taking for me. You know what I'm saying? I'm taking time for me. And I don't want to, somebody DM me yesterday. And it was like, I don't know what the girl said. I would pull my phone out, but I know it's not good to have your phone in your hand while you're doing a video. So that's something I've been working on. She DM'd me last night. And she said, I mean, she's very pretty. She's hot as hell. She says, she don't say hi, hello, or nothing. The messenger says, Mr. Cryer, so you're single now? I didn't respond right away. I responded like an hour later. I was like, yes, I am. Very single. And so she responded immediately. I mean, immediately. Like, she was like literally sitting there, you know, waiting on me to respond. She says, so what do you think of sugar mama? Just like that. She says, what do you think of a sugar mama? So I didn't know how to take that at first. So I sat there for a few minutes and got to contemplating, like, what should my response be to this? You know what my response was? I sent you a message. I was like, listen, I'm not interested. I said, thank you, but I'm not interested. Thanks for reaching out to me. I said, have a blessed day. She sent me a message back, and she was like, so you scared of young chicks or something like that? And so I was like, what the hell? So I responded back to her. I said, listen, now maybe I shouldn't be responding, but hell, why not? Sometimes it's not good to open up someone's message, and they know that you open the message up, obviously, and then not respond to them. So my response was, listen, I said, but thank you for reaching out again. She sent another message, and the third message, she was like, well, why do you want to be single? As if, like, you know, I don't have a choice. I said, listen, I want to be single, and I don't want to date right now. And I said, I'm not interested. And then I said, and then she sent a question mark. Why? Fourth message, I'm like, oh my God, just a question mark. Why? I said, my response was because I don't want the headache and the drama that's associated with the relationship. Anyway, that question is like a big thing. It's like, would I ever date one of my exes again? The thing about that is, you know, it would all have to be surrounding the circumstances, because I have had some pretty good people come into my life. And again, like I said in previous videos, I've had some people exit my life. And you know, do I have some regrets? Yes, I do have some regrets. I don't have a lot of regrets, but I do have some regrets. You know, I feel like a lot of choices and, you know, decisions that I made was actually for the best. And I also believe that some decisions and choices that I made was not for the best. So I would say yes and no to that situation. And again, these are questions that I'm answering without an actual Q&A being involved. But if you guys, oh, speaking of Q&A, if you guys want another Q&A, please leave me some questions in the description box after this video down below. Just some straightforward questions. I was gonna actually do like a live, and I'm still working on a live, man. Guys, I've been trying to do a live for you guys, but I've been so freaking busy. I've been busy, busy, busy. But I don't wanna seem like I'm jumping all over the place. So back to the topic. So basically, yes and no, I would actually, you know, redate an ex that I was with. But like I said, it would all depend on the circumstances that led to the breakup. So that's one thing. Now, the next thing that a lot of people been asking me, okay, so I did touch on, would I date one of my exes? Would I have another baby? I forget what the first one was. But there was another one too that a lot of people was asking me. They were asking me, because I used to always say, like, when I became divorced in Indiana, I always said that I would not date anyone in Indiana. That's just the rule that I have, you know. So people are like, well, so if you date, are you going to date someone in Texas, in Houston, Texas? And have I met anyone in Texas? Have I been on any dates since I've been in Texas? The question to that is no, I have not dated anyone in Texas. I've been here, let's see, July, August, September, October, November, December. Holy cow, I've been here 7 months. I have not dated anyone in the state of Texas yet. Will I date anyone here? It all depends. You know, if I meet someone here and the vibe is cool, then I'm not gonna say no. I mean, because everybody is not the same. But as of right now today, have I met anyone? No, I haven't. It's like the people that I do come across, they live in other states and stuff like that. And y'all all know as well as I know that long distance relationships do not work. I have tried it before. And the long distance relationship that I was in at one time that I tried before was actually, it was really, really hard in the beginning. It was so hard because we had talked for like a whole entire year before we ever came face to face. She even motivated me to buy an iPhone. so that way we can quit talking on Facebook Messenger. Now that was, now that right there was a really good relationship. You know, I said long distance relationships don't work, and her and I both agreed that, wow, it was stressful. I mean, I had missed Valentine's Day, I had missed birthday, where I was supposed to have flew on in or drove in. And, you know, it was like, man, you know, here I am driving 17 hours once a month to Indiana to visit my son. At the time, she only lived 10 hours away from me. So it was like, I was like, man, that is a long drive. But I find myself driving 17, 18 hours on a consistent basis now. So it was like, damn, you know, I could have did that then. But long distance relationships is kind of strenuous, but that one was starting to work out really well. So I won't say all long distance relationships don't work. You know, some long distance relationships do actually work. I mean, they actually really do work. I literally forgot about my chicken sitting here. As y'all know how I am, I get the talking and running my mouth. I just get the talking and running my mouth. But, and my chicken got cold. But thing is, man. What? Is she trying to yell at me or what? Are you yelling at Papa? She's smiling and giggling her butt off. He is so beautiful, man. But being around my, you know, being around my grandkids, man, it really makes me think a lot about having another baby, because I consider myself as like a family man, family oriented. She just threw a toy at me. No, she didn't just throw a toy at me. But yeah, so it does kind of make you think about it, you know, being around kids, man. But it's just a really nice thing, man. So anyway, man, I'm not going to make this video entirely long, because I had to keep getting up and stopping the camera and doing different things, because my baby's got to come first. But anyway, man, you guys leave me a comment after this video. Let me know if you like this video. You want me to continue doing videos like it, this time where I'm actually eating and talking to you guys instead of eating, talking, and getting up. I just had a lot of things going on. But I love you guys, man. I thank you guys so much for continuously and consistently always watching my videos. All you new subscribers who recently joined the Cryer family, man, I thank you guys. I feel really honored. I went to sleep last night. I was at 128,000 subscribers. I woke up this morning almost 131,000. So I think it's safe to say we are on the road to 150,000 subscribers, man. And I love you guys for that. And I feel so honored and grateful. And so I am going to do some shout outs today. Granny, you wanna do some shout outs with me? No. You don't wanna do any shout outs with Pawpaw? Huh? Why not? No shout outs with Pawpaw. I don't get it. So my first shout out today is going to go to Maggie Perez. Okay. And my second shout out is going to go to Kanissa Borders. And LaDawn Harris. Three shout outs today, guys, because I made up for the two videos I did yesterday I didn't do shout outs in, and today's video. So man, anyway, leave me some ideas on a video that you want me to do for you guys. I know you guys want to prank so bad. I can't say nothing, but a prank is coming, guys. I just can't say nothing right now because a lot of people watch my channel. But I love you guys. Until next time, it's the D, the A, the M, the I, the O, N. And I love you guys. And I'm going to see you in the next video. Peace.